What we have here is somewhat similar to what we did with the circles for each one of our data points. Since we use this over and over again in practice, I would most likely abstract this if conditional into some function outside of this block of code. But for clarity's sake and understanding, I've written it out. And with this legend, these groups we've just created, we're going to append a circle for each of the bound data points. Set the y attribute of that circle to be some variable I times 30. Previously, we've only used accessor functions like this to access the datum that was bound. But if we specify in our function two arguments, d, I in this case, we actually get the index of the data point. In this case, we only have two data points, home team and others. So I of 0 is going to be home team, I of 1 is going to be others. And depending on which position we're at in the array we passed to the data binding function, we're simply going to increment the y position by 30 pixels. This might seem silly for a legend that only has two items in it, but let's say we had a complex chart that maybe had 10 different lines or types of circles or shapes we've drawn. We wouldn't have to want to specify either in the data some value or hard code in the exact pixel every one of those 10 lines should show up at in the legend. For the radius and the fill, nothing new here. We simply check, is the datum home team? If it is, we're going to draw it to be the same size as the home team circles, radius times multiplier. And if it's not the home team, just draw it the same size as all the other blue circles. And for the fill, if it's the home team, fill it to be red, and otherwise, make it blue. I'm going to comment out this last bit of the legend code that appends text, save my file, and see what shows up on the page. Refreshing the page, we have our initial chart, and here we see two circles that seem to be floating in space. But again, we haven't appended the text that corresponds to what each of these circles represents. We've only drawn a circle the same size and color as the one we want to label. So now let's go back to the code and actually add text so that a reader knows what the small blue circles are and what the larger red circles are.